everyone, this is Palak Vadaliya from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. Today we will discuss the subject that is Control System Design, and in this subject we will discuss our unit number 4, that is the last unit of our syllabus of Control System Design, that is Introduction to Robust Control. And our today's topic is what is a robust control system and system sensitivity to the parameter variation. And which parameter we have to consider? That is what G. G is what is a system, and H, that is what is a feedback. So let's start our today's session. See, first of all, we will discuss what is robust control. Then, in a control theory, a robust control is an approach to the controller to design that deals with the uncertainty. That means sometimes what will happen, you design your system and because of some uncertainty you are not going to achieve the goal that what actually you want. So the robust control method are designed the function properly to provide the uncertain parameter or disturbance that is found in some set. That means that system will work perfectly or right in the presence of some uncertain parameter or some, we can say, the disturbances. Now, what is robust control system? A robust control system has basically designed performance despite the presence of significant plant, process and uncertainty. Right? Now next, you see the system is robust when it has a low sensitivity. That means if any parameter changes, then your system stability should not change. That's why the system is robust when it has a low sensitivity. Then a system is stable over the wide range of the parameter variations. Okay? Then a system performance or the performance continues to meet a specification in the presence of set of change in a system parameters. Now we will see what is the need of feedback control system. That it decreases the sensitivity of the system variation in the parameter of the process, that is G of S. Because see, in a feedback we have a one H of S, right? That is goes back to the input with the sum input. So is there any disturbances present in the system that you can eliminate with help of the what? It's a feedback. Then that is easy of the control and the adjustment of the transient response of the system. Now we know very well what is a transient response, that is a peak time, rise time, delay time, maximum overshoot, like that. And that is improvement in the rejection of the disturbances and noise signal within the system. Because based on the feedback, because here you have a feedback, so you can reject the disturbance or you can see it in some parameter variation. Now the improvement in the rejection of the steady state error of the system. We know that what is the steady state error? E of S. Now if you want to improve that steady state error, then after we require the what as a feedback control system. Now next we will discuss that is the sensitivity of control system to parameter variation. So first we will see what is the sensitivity. The term system sensitivity is used to describe the relative variation of all our transfer function, that is what? It's an output upon input, C of S upon R of S. Due to the variation in the G of S, that is defined below, that sensitivity, that is percentage change in a transfer function, that is T of S, divided by percentage change, that is in a system, that is what? It's a G of S. Right. So you can mathematically you can say that as Tg, that is del D by T, that is what is a percentage change in the transfer function divided by percentage change in a what? In a system. So the notation is what? That is as T and G. So this is referred as the sensitivity of transfer function T with respect to what? G. Instead of G, if I write H, then my equation will become delta T by T upon delta H by H. So that shows the system sensitivity, or we can say the system sensitivity of transfer function T with respect to H. So in general, if I write S instead of T, if I write alpha, and instead of G, if I write beta, then my equation is become what? It's a del alpha by alpha upon del beta by beta. So that is the sensitivity of alpha with respect to what? Beta. Now next, that is, see, this is what we just want to find out the sensitivity of our closed loop system and open loop system, and then we will see the comparison between this. Okay, so first of all, you just consider this is a closed loop system. Our system, that is what is the G of S. Feedback element is what? H of S. And this is what is a negative feedback control system. Because see, the H of S is what? It's a minus. And input is R of S, output is what? Is a C of S. Now, see, the transfer function is what? It's a Laplace ratio of Laplace transform of output upon input when all initial conditions are what? It's a zero. So T that equal to what? It's a C of S upon R of S. Now, here, we know that in a closed loop system, if I want to find out the transfer function, then the equation is what? It's a G of S upon 1 plus, why plus? Because it's a negative feedback control system. So plus G of S into H of S. Now see, we are interested to find out the system sensitivity with the parameter variation, that is what? It's a G. So our equation is what? Is delta T by T upon delta G by G. Now we have the value of T that we will substitute here later. But just simplify this equation. See, we can write down delta T by delta G multiplied by what? G by T. Just rearrange, or we can say we just simplify the whole equation. Now here, see, this is the equation of the sensitivity. Now we have the transfer function T. That equal to what? It's a G upon 1 plus GH. Right. So simply what we will do? We will substitute this value of T in above equation. So as GT, that is become del, that is instead of T, that is G 1 plus GH upon delta G multiplied by G. And instead of T, what we will substitute? That is G upon 1 plus GH. Now just simplify this. Then we will get the sensitivity of closed loop system. See, this is our equation. Now first of all, I want to find out the first term, that is differentiation of that term with respect to what? G. Then we will use the division rule. That is, first of all, what we will write? That is G, differentiation of the G with respect to G, that is of 1. And just write the denominator as it is, that is 1 plus GH minus, you just consider your numerator, that is G as it is. And the differentiation of the denominator bracket, that is 1 plus GH. So the differentiation of the 1 is 0 plus differentiation of the GH, that is all become what? X of H, like this, and then upon denominator square. So it's what? It's a 1 plus GH whole square. Now see, the GG is cancelled, then here what we have, that is 1 plus G into H. Now this 1 plus GH, and here also we have a 1 plus GH whole square, so it is cancelled. So what we get? 1 plus GH minus GH. So this GH, GH is cancelled. So the sensitivity of closed loop system, a transfer function with respect to G, that is what? It's a 1 upon 1 plus G into H. Now, similarly, as I said earlier, we will derive the sensitivity of open loop system. So here, see, this is what? It's an open loop system. Now, what is the transfer function T? Of course, it's what? It's an output, Laplace transform of output upon input. But here, it's an open loop system. So directly, we can say that C of S upon R of S, that equal to what? It's a G. Now, the equation is remain same, that is sensitivity of transfer function with respect to G. So del T by del G multiply by G by T. Now you just substitute the value of T, that is what is with G. Now this all thing is cancelled. Del G cancel, G G cancel. So what we will get, that is sensitivity of open loop system is always 1. That means if you find any change in the system, definitely any parameter of the system, then definitely that will affect on the stability of that system. Okay, you cannot tune or you cannot control, because it's one, it's a open loop system. So if you remember, then this difference we have discussed when we study the difference between open loop system and closed loop system. So the sensitivity of closed loop system with respect to variation in G is reduced by the factor 1 plus GH as compared to open loop system. Because the sensitivity of open loop system is what? It's a 1. And the sensitivity of the closed loop system is what? It's a 1 upon 1 plus G into H. Now next, we will discuss or we will find the sensitivity of the system parameter variation, that is what? H. Earlier we find the sensitivity with the system parameter, that is G. Now we will consider, that is H. So S, T, H. And we know that the equation is for del T by del T, del T by T upon del H by H. Instead of G, here I have what? It's a H. So likewise you can consider any parameter. So here this is del T by del H upon multiply by H by T. And we know that for the closed loop system, let's we'll discuss with, for the closed loop system. So the transfer function, that is T, that equal to G upon 1 plus GH. Now you just substitute this. That is, instead of T, we will substitute G upon 1 plus GH. Here also G upon 1 plus GH. Now we have to find out the differentiation of the first term with respect to H. Again we will use the division rule, that is differentiation of the G with respect to H is what? It's a 0. Then you just multiply 0 with the denominator 1 plus GH minus G as it is, and the differentiation of the that bracket, that is 1 plus GH. So the differentiation of the 1 is 0 and GH, that is what? It's a G divided by 1 plus GH whole square, and you just rearrange this term. That is H 1 plus GH divided by what? It's a G. Now here, see here also we have a 1 plus GH, here also we have a 1 plus GH. So that term is cancelled. So in a denominator only we will get what? 1 plus GH. And see here you will get minus G square. But here also we have a G. So minus G square and G. So that is cancelled. So what we get here, that is minus G, but that you have to multiply with the H. So in a numerator we will get minus GH, and in a denominator we will get 1 plus GH. So this equation of the sensitivity of closed loop system with the parameter variation, that is of H. So for the large value of GH, the sensitivity of the feedback system with respect to H, that is what is approach to unity. Okay? Now, see in our next session, we will discuss about the sensitivity of first order system, second order system, and then we will discuss the robust PID controller. So I hope this session is clear. Thank you.